I want to welcome you in the name of Jesus, the Savior of the world. We are gathered together this morning to worship, to proclaim Christ crucified and risen, and to remember before God our sister Janet Marie Miller Quick, to give thanks for her life, and to commend her to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another in our grief and in our sorrow. The Apostle Paul reminds us that when we were baptized into Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We are buried, therefore, with him by baptism unto death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. Let us pray. O God of grace and God of glory, we remember before you today our sister Janet. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Our first reading comes from the book of Jeremiah, in the 31st chapter. Hear the word of the Lord, O nations, and declare it in the coastlands far away. Say, the one who scattered Israel will gather them and keep them as a shepherd a flock. Then shall the young women rejoice in the dance, and the young men and old shall be merry. I will turn their mourning into joy. I will comfort them and give them gladness for sorrow. And a second reading from the prophet Micah. The Lord has told you, O mortal, what is good. And what does the Lord require of you? But to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God. Please join us in singing, How Great Thou Art.
Thank you.
A reading from Paul's letter to the church at Philippi. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say, rejoice. Let your gentleness be made known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. Today we gather in sadness, but also with a note of celebration, to say goodbye to Jan. 62 years. In some respects, that's a long, long period of time. But today, it's all too short. But Janet had her own difficulties in life, but she had a life that was full of joys and sorrows, challenges and achievements, and along with laughing and crying. And so today we gather to say goodbye and to pay our last respects. And one way to do that, Donetta has some things to share, some memories. Yes, if you'll come right up here and speak loudly and carry a big stick. Oh, no, that was soft.
I love this church. I owe that to Janet. I owe a lot to Janet. I owe many, 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 many things to Janet. She was my friend. She was my caretaker. She was my surrogate mother, even though we were about the same age. She never, ever, ever once let me down in anything. And I've only known her for 8 years. But there's a lot of people like me out there. A lot. A lot. I'm just blessed to be one of them. I'm going to try to make this quick, but in Matthew 25, there's a parable, you know, about the master giving three of his slaves an equal amount of money to each one of them, and then leaving and coming back, you know, and seeing what each slave had done with the money, the talents. And, you know, we all know the story, you know. And I'm just going to skip to the end. And the moral of the story is to use your gifts and to grow them in God. And that parable just kind of sums it all up when it comes to Janet, you know. God gave her gifts, and she used them, and she grew them. And she would just keep adding stuff to her plate. She just didn't stop. Lord, when I met Janet, I'm just going to do this real quick, and I'm going to forget things, I know it. But when I met Janet, it was just me, Janet, and Minta. But in 1 week, you know, Janet would serve the Otero. She was the president of the Otero Hunger Coalition. And this was just in like 1 week, in 1 week. We'd do 3 Walmart pickups. We'd do 3 soup kitchens. We'd redistribute that food. We'd do the food bank. this was all when I didn't work too, but I know I'm forgetting stuff. I wrote it all down, but the Good Samaritan Fund, the 3 Walmart pickups, the 1 Lowe's grocery store pickup, the Roadrunner Food Bank, she had an unprecedented organizational skill. You don't know what goes into just doing one soup kitchen, never mind 3 a week. And all the while, she kept adding more and more and more to her plate, and she would just keep doing it, not to mention her physical restraints that she had, that she never let get in her way. I couldn't have done it. And she was under a lot of criticism for things that she did and how she did it, you know. But nobody else stepped up to the plate, and she did it her way, and she did it. She fought for the homeless, and she fought for the people who couldn't fight for themselves. And she let it be known that it was going to get done. The only thing that didn't get done was that one dream of having that one kitchen that was 24/7, 7 days a week. We just couldn't find the building. But anyway, I'm going to skip to the end now. And thank Janet for her gifts, for God's glory. And know that when I pray and I tell God to say hi to Janet for me, I know that He does. I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful for my tears. I'm grateful for all the people that she helped, and all the I'm sorry for all the people that she didn't get to help. I thank her for her sticking up for all those people. I thank her for, I'm wrapping it up now. I thank her for coming to my first year's sobrietyship. All those years ago when she didn't even really know me, but she came and she represented my family who couldn't be here, and she became my family that night. And I'm especially grateful for her family who took me in, but I'm especially grateful for Minta. She gave me Minta. We're an odd pair. But we work together. We work. Because she's just like her. And I'm especially grateful for that. And I miss you, Janet.
Thank you, Donetta. Donald? You just have to deal with that.
Well, if y'all know me, she'd have slapped me for that right there. Get up there, go. But the last few days I've thought to myself, if she was here, what would she say to all of you? And I think what comes to mind is, stop your crying. We got work to do. You know. In the truest sense of it, there's people that need fed, there's people that need a roof, it's getting cold, you know, that kind of thing. And that was what she cared for, you know. Herself was always kind of back to the side, and Menta and Michael and Cheyenne and I would all jump her and, you know, need to slow down. She didn't have it in her to slow down, she just didn't. This is what she loved doing. It's what she loved doing. And that's what we take away from it. You know, when we leave here, everybody's gonna say, you know, if there's anything we can do for you guys, just let us know. And we thank you for that. But really the only thing she would want is to go out and try to be a little bit more like her. That's the only thing we ask. Go out and help somebody today. Thank you, guys. Thank you, everybody that's here, that's supported her through all the years, through everything. Friendships, through hard times. You know, she never let anybody really know how she was feeling. It was always, what are we doing? What can we do today? What can we accomplish today? One of the last things I remember telling her, she'd just, you know, kind of, she was in the hospital and she'd woken up and was kind of coherent again and talking to us. And she was, oh, how's the kids? How's the kids? That was first. Did Michael buy his house? That was next. Well, we need to get money into this account because this is going to happen. And I looked at her. I was like, woman, stop running the 501c3 from your bed, please. But she never stopped. Thank you all.
Just tell everybody thank you for coming here and supporting her on all the stuff that she did. Like everybody said, my mom was real active, even though with her being on oxygen didn't stop her from our Boy Scout camps, to baseball games, to my football games. Didn't stop her. She's probably laughing at me right now because I'm crying. But when she first got on the oxygen, I told her that she couldn't spank me no more. And boy, did that foot go up so fast. Everything. My mom was there for anybody who needed it, from Gilbert and Mariah to their family, the Fierros, my friends. They're like Sunstorm. And when I got that phone call when Donald called me, when she ended up in the hospital, I was at work. That's why probably nobody recognized me. I was always gone. We got there to the hospital. I went to the house first when I got back, check on my dad. And he was smoking. My dad smokes like a chimney in the house, and my mom didn't like that. So we got there to the hospital, and I told my mom, hey, you need to get up. Dad's smoking. Even though she had a tube in her mouth that day, she woke up, and that look on her face that she wanted to just get home and just slap him around a little bit. She was joking even there with the tube. Got told by the nurse I had to get her blood pressure back down because she was laughing too much. Then we got the house and we told her that we got the house and we'll be retiring later. I guess she got me the house. The Lord wanted my mom to be there to run the big soup kitchen. But I just want to say thank you guys. She loved every single one of y'all. Like she was her own children, her own family. She's a big part of this community that nobody really recognized. So, thank you.
This is a mic that I can't control. Janet could control a mic. Oh, never mind. That was different. I had the blessing of meeting Janet. I haven't been here that long, and when I found out that they were accepting visitors at the hospital, I took advantage of it, because one of the things that I knew about Janet was all from the picture and the reputation. And I got to know Janet a whole lot more, only having met her a short time, because I met Janet through the eyes of all of you. And she was a woman who was much larger than life. And like you said, the Energizer Bunny, she kept going and going and going. But there was a passion that was authentic, a caring. She understood about justice for all people. She understood about God's justice, too. And God's justice is declaring God's love for all people. She is indeed much larger than life, and that's why from Philippians, these would be the words that she would speak to us all. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. And she would want to emphasize that again, to continue to reach out. Reach out with love and compassion. And then the peace of God you will know in a whole new way. The candle that stands next to her picture there and remains is a candle that reminds us that Janet was a sinner redeemed by God. That she was indeed a person loved by God. And she in return tried to live out that love by sharing it in any way she could. Yeah, it was hard to get her to talk about herself. It's hard to get her to say, yeah, I'm not feeling good. But she had a bigger passion, and that was a concern for all people, and especially those who were not able to do simply by themselves. So today, we remember a legacy that indeed will live on. Because we will keep on doing the things that we learned from her. And as we recall the memories, the times when she could be really rather vocal about things, and maybe a little pushy, we might say, but behind it all was that sense of compassion and love. And so today, in the midst of our sadness, let us thank God for the life that we shared with Janet. And let us thank God for the gift of life he has given to us. And let us thank God for the precious gift of Jesus Christ, a gift that brings life and wholeness to us all. Today, as we remember, we thank God, and blessed be the memory of Janet Marie Miller Quick. Thanks be to God. If you please join me in singing a song of the grace of God, which guided Janet in her life, and now she knows in all its fullness. We have one more addition. Just a few more memories to share.
Hi, my name is Kaylee, and well, I knew Janet before I actually knew what friends were. And I didn't want her to go, but if we just stay happy, I bet that'll make her happy, so. I'm just try and stay happy for her. She's always here in spirit.
Hi, my name is Ted Duran, and I ran into Janet. She helped me out about 5 years back. I had some financial problems when I got back from Afghanistan. And I had a little trailer park, and everybody kind of dumped on me, and I was stuck with the bill, shut off all the power and stuff. And I didn't really know her. I came over here and made a request to get some help. She, without knowing anything about me, of course, she gave me the money and stuff, and we got the power back on. And then, so I just, you know, got to thinking about, you know, God coming into my life and stuff like that. So I asked her if there was anything I could do to repay. And she said she had an enchilada dinner going. And I'm trying to figure, it's probably 4 or 5 years back, but I told her, well, you know, when I was a kid, I worked at Margo's and I'd make a few enchiladas, you know. So I came and I helped her do that. And I didn't, at the whole time, I didn't know what the charity was for. And it was for her to go to Arizona with her cancer treatment. And then I found out later on that she had beat it, you know. So I from then on, I always thought that there's a reason why people run into other people throughout, you know, their lives and stuff like that. And I just wanted everybody to know that, you know, I ran back into her doing these food drives and stuff like that and didn't have a clue as to how much stuff she has done for this community. There's very few people in this world that really make this place a better, this whole world a better place to be in. And she is definitely a woman that has done that for all of us. And I just want to, you know, send my regards to the family and stuff like that. And I'm here, and I hope that I can help out, you know, just do what I can for her, because I'm sure that's what she wants all of us to do. Thank you for your time.
In the peace of God, let us pray. Almighty God, in holy baptism, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion in the mystical body of Christ our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share the new life in Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give courage and faith to all who mourn, and assure and certain hope in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may have the strength for the days ahead. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that the world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Help us, O Lord, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and to trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And God of all grace, we give you thanks, because by his death, our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection, he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also. And that neither death, nor life, nor things present, nor things to come will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Lead us not as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, power, and glory. Let us commend Janet to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Janet Marie Miller Quick. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy and into the blessed rest of everlasting peace and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. As we leave this place, we do so thanking God for the time that we had spent with Janet and the witness that she was to us. One of her big things was always food and helping people with food. And so please join us for a time of fellowship in the fellowship hall. If you'll please follow the family to the fellowship hall, and it's a time to share the stories about Janet. Let us go in peace in the name of Christ. Amen. Please rise.